Saturn, the sixth planet in our solar system, is the most remarkable. Best viewed through a telescope, the yellow and gold gossamer rings encircling the planet are not only its most outstanding feature, but also the one that make it instantly recognizable. Galileo Galilei was the first to observe Saturn's rings in 1610. 45 years later, using a more powerful telescope, Dutch astronomer Christiaan Huygens claimed that Saturn had a thin flat ring. Advances in science in the years following taught us that Saturn actually has many rings. These were made of billions of particles of ice and rock, ranging in size from a grain of salt to the size of a building. The particles are believed to be debris left over from comets, asteroids, and exploded moons. A recent study also suggested the rings may be the dwarf planet carcasses. So from where did Saturn get these rings? Formerly, scientists claimed that the rings may have come with the planet itself, when the solar system itself was being formed, 4 billion years ago. This was a natural assumption because it was believed that there must have been a lot of dust and particles that helped create this ring, before everything eventually settled down. But the two missions sent by NASA concluded that the rings were much younger, only about 10 to 100 million years. This information was first sent by NASA's Voyager spacecraft, when it crossed the planet at extremely close quarters in the 1980s. Later, in 2017, NASA spacecraft Cassini was sent to specifically unearth information about Saturn and its rings. And surprisingly, it supported the Voyager's findings. That means, when dinosaurs were roaming the Earth 4 billion years ago, Saturn was sans its rings. As much as we would like to regale the beautiful rings of Saturn, NASA scientists have recently come up with a doomsday prediction concerning their survival. There are chances that the rings will disappear soon. In some time, Saturn will no longer have its beautiful, gossamer circle. Sadly, the rings are depleting even as you watch this video today. This loss is attributed to what has been termed as the ring phenomenon. Having said this though, the destruction of Saturn's rings is not a new development. Unbeknownst to us, this particle-by-particle destruction has been going on for millions of years. As we saw earlier, the rings, which are made of ice particles, rocks and dust, are captured by the planet's gravitational pull, forming an orbital path around it. But each time a meteorite crashes into the ring, it disturbs the balance of the particles and adds an electric charge to them. The same occurs during a geomagnetic storm generated by the Sun. Saturn's electromagnetic field pulls the charged particles from the ring towards it, where they vaporize into the planet's cloudy atmosphere. And just like that, bit by bit, the rings disappear. This is called the ring rain and is what is likely going to be the death of Saturn's rings. NASA's prediction that with time Saturn will lose its rings in entirety has been supported by space agencies from across the globe, like the European Space Agency, ESA, and Japan's Space Agency, JAXA. While this prediction is likely to come true, it is thankfully not going to be in our lifetime. Scientists believe that it will take at least 300 million years for Saturn to lose all its rings. However, it will lose its core rings in 100 million years. What do you guys think? The words twinkle twinkle little star may put a baby to sleep, but they aren't precisely accurate outside of Earth's atmosphere. A correct version would be, emit, giant balls of gas. Not so catchy, right? Stars, the dazzling beacons of light that come alive when the sky darkens, have always piqued our interest. They've been worshipped as gods, used to measure the passage of time, and as a means of navigating the planet. But, do we possess enough knowledge about them? We have been able to observe and study millions of stars thanks to our advanced telescopes. They have enlightened us about the universe's deepest secrets. NASA's Hubble Space Telescope has obtained photographs of the most distant star ever observed, which appears to provide a fascinating view into the primordial cosmos. It has set a new benchmark by detecting this distant star. This star is believed to have existed within the first billion years, after the Big Bang. Astronomers have named it Arundel, an Old English name, which means morning star. Arundel's light has traveled an estimated 12.9 billion years to reach Earth, a considerable leap over the previous most distant star, which was 9 billion years old. Because of an unusual cosmic alignment, the observations were feasible, and Arundel may be the only solitary star from this time that we will ever observe. Studying Arundel will provide a window into a hitherto unknown era of the universe. This is a groundbreaking discovery that opens up a whole new field of research, by allowing huge stars to be directly observed when the cosmos was young, and star formation was just beginning. It is thought to be at least 50 times the mass of the Sun and millions of times as bright, making it one of the most massive stars ever discovered. A dazzling star like this would typically be undetectable. Even the whole galaxy is simply a speck of light at such great distances. Astronomers will be able to quantify the star's brightness and temperature, as well as gain insight into the makeup of the first generation of stars, according to the scheduled observations. These stars evolved before the universe was filled with the heavy elements created by successive generations of big stars, and they are the forerunners of the stars we see now in the sky. The James Webb Space Telescope, JWST, which launched in December 2021, and is now preparing for science operations, should be able to determine whether Arundel is a single star system or a cluster of star systems. Its optics are superior to Hubble's and far more advanced. Both these magnificent telescopes are expected to work together and bombard us with loads of new information about the cosmos. Examining Arundel will provide a glimpse into a time in the cosmos that we are unfamiliar with. It's like, we've been reading a fascinating novel, but we've started from the second chapter, and now we'll get to see how it all began. What do you guys think?